Hey everybody, this is Ori from AstroWeb, and I'm going to introduce to you the Shopify Discounts module, basically allowing the business owners and marketers, etc., to create promotions, coupon codes, discount codes, automatic promotions, etc. So I'm going to teach you how to do it, walk you through the concepts, and if you have any questions, would be happy to answer. Okay, so what I'm doing is I set up a demo store just for this video, just the store itself. I just added some random products and things like that. So I created a category, called the Adidas, and I put some stuff in. Okay, so I'm going to discounts right here, and under discounts, there's two types of discounts you can do. Now, all of these discounts are provided to the customer after they add products to the shopping cart and they proceed to checkout, right? So there's two things. So the first type is discount codes, which means the customer has to receive an actual discount code, an actual coupon code with some kind of word, right? Like 5 off or happy holidays or Merry Christmas, things like that. They input it in the checkout page and then they can actually go and get the discount and proceed to checkout. The automatic discounts are discounts that as long as they have added to cart and they've proceeded, they can get the promotion without having to enter, copy and paste a coupon code or get something by email or things like that. So let's go ahead and let's create some of them. Okay, so discount codes, I'm going to click on create either here or here, right? So kind of the same, discount code. Okay, so first, I'm going to walk you through the types, the things that are here, and then I'm going to create quite a few examples to show you everything. Okay, so first of all, it's the actual type of the discount code. So if you're giving someone the code, for example, Merry Christmas, you're going to Merry Christmas 5. They're going to get that and input it. So you can either make your own or you can generate a code. Usually making your own is better because generate code is kind of crazy, right? It's kind of difficult, not easy to type it, but sometimes you need that, okay? So types, what kind of types? So you have either a percentage off, like 20% off your products, a fixed amount, $5 off. Free shipping, obviously you get free shipping, and then you have a buy X, get Y. For example, buy 2 of these, get 1 free, or buy 5 of these, get the 6th one for 30% off. You can do that as well, okay? Discount amount, and then all. So I'm going to revisit this in a second. So the next one is the applies to. So it basically specifies if the promotion, like for example, 20% off, applies to the entire cart, the entire order, or some of the products that are inside, or some of the products based on the product or based on the collection, the category, okay? And then you can specify, next one is the minimum requirements. In order to apply the actual promotion after the customer put it, does there have to be a specific minimum amount in the cart? For example, buy at least $50 and get 5 off. Or is it buy at least a certain quantity like this one? So buy at least 7 pieces and get 20% off, okay? Customer eligibility, you can specify that anyone who has a coupon can use it, or certain groups of customers, which we'll show you a little later, which means you can define in your customer section right here, you can set up different groups, for example, VIPs or employees of a certain company, or new customers that they just registered, or many other things, and I'll show you some examples. Or you can go for specific customers, which will show you the details. Next one is the usage limits. So how many times can the promotion be used in total? And do you want to limit it to 1 per customer? And then the last one is the actual active date, the start date, end date. You can specify only a start date, or you can add a start date and an end date, okay? So once you set up everything, you'll have the summaries here. So let's jump through really popular ones that businesses use, okay? First one is gonna be Merry Christmas, 5% off, okay? So I made a coupon code which I can give my customers, and I click on percentage and I type in 5%. And I wanna apply it to the entire order with no minimum requirements, right? You can buy $5 and you'll still get 5% off. You can buy $1,000, you'll still get 5% off. And it's eligible to every customer. As long as you have the coupon code that's right here, you can use it. And I'm going to limit it to only the first 100 people to use it will get it. And I can only, I'll only limit it for 1 per customer. And now I see my summary. I can review it, 5% off for everybody, limit 100% 100 usage, 1 per customer. and active immediately. No end date. In this case, I'm going to click on save. Okay, so now I'm going to take this coupon code and I'm going to act like a customer. And this is, if you remember, for all products. I'm just going to go here. I'm going to go to this product. I'm just going to add one. Okay, and if you remember, it was 5%. Now, coupon codes are only applied in the checkout, so you can't see it in the shopping cart page. You proceed to checkout. This was the old thing, okay? Now, I don't have a promotion, right? So if I actually copy-paste it, then I should get my promotion. It applied, and I have my promotion off. Okay, great. So let's remove this, okay? And let's make another variation, okay? So I can edit it. Now, I can also disable my promotion, and I can also grab the link itself to the promotion, okay? Get a shareable link. I can actually copy it. So if someone goes with that URL, it can apply it automatically. So let's go here, for example, Adidas. I'm going to choose a different product and add to cart. View the cart. Proceed to checkout. Automatically apply. So it's really nice to have a URL, or you can copy paste this and give your customers a coupon code. Okay, so let's continue. So what else can we do here? Let's make a few more exceptions. Let's say, for example, that I want to apply only to certain products. Okay, so let's say I want to apply certain products. Let's say, for example, I don't want to apply it to this product. I want to apply it to, go here. I only want to apply it to this product. I'm going to copy this product name. I'm going to edit this and say I only want it to apply to these products. I'm going to search for that. I pasted it in, checkbox, and add. So now if I save this, and as a customer, I refresh the page, this product will not give me the coupon code, right? Okay, should not give me. Let's refresh. And let's actually take the promotion and apply it. And it should not apply. Why? Because it's not a product that I said it would apply. Now, if I go ahead and I modify this to collections, but I select Adidas, right? Or I can select multiple, of course, and I save it. Now, if you remember before, both the backpack and the shoes are in the Adidas, so it should apply. And I refresh, and I got my promotion, okay? I got my promotion right here. You can see that. Okay, so what else can I do? So we covered the applies to. We have the minimum amount. Let's show that. So for example, minimum amount, let's say you have to have $100 inside to apply. Minimum amount, $100. Click on save. If I refresh, it won't apply because I'm under $100, right? I'm under 100 here. Okay, you see it doesn't apply. But if I make it, for example, minimum $80, then it should apply. Okay, it applied. Now, if I make it, and I can do the same thing with quantity, right? So if I do minimum 2 quantity, then I only have 1 quantity here, so it shouldn't apply. Okay, great. So yeah, I think you understand the concept. Okay, what else do we have from here? So I'm going to actually remove this, and I'm going to show you the other types of examples. Okay, so let's go here. Let's disable. And I'm going to go back to discount codes. And once you create one, you'll have a table here, which you can edit, etc. So click on create. We're still working on the discount code. We haven't gotten to the automatic one. I'm going to say 10% off, okay? And let's do this $10 off, $11 off, okay? Dollars off, okay? And I put here 11. I can apply it again to certain collections, certain products, minimum quantities, etc. This time I'm going to do, if you have at least 2, you'll get $11 off. And I'm going to apply it to, I'll show you in next step one more time. So I'm going to save this and go ahead and refresh. And if you remember, I have to have 2 quantity, right? So first of all, I'm going to try to apply it and I'm going to refresh. Okay, so I don't have it because I need two quantity. I'm going to go back, type in two, and go to the checkout. And you see right here, here's the discount. Okay, great. So let's remove this and let's make one more. Okay, I'm going to disable this. And I'm going to go back and I'm going to create a new one. So I hope I'm not going too quick. Obviously, you can pause and move the video. And if you have any questions, I'm happy to answer. Okay, free shipping is pretty self-explanatory. You can specify the countries that they're shipping to, right? So let's go here, go to information and cart. So for example, I can specify only to, for example, US. And I'm going to save. Okay, now I already have free shipping already because I didn't specify in this demo store, but I think you understand the concept. Okay, so free ship 100, for example. I would create that. Right here. Okay, so I would get a free shipping. Now, obviously, I already have free shipping, so it's not really helpful, but you understand that it can apply. And the last one that's also pretty popular, which I'm going to disable this, is the buy X, get Y. So let's see an example. Okay, great. So all expired. I'm going to create a new one, discount code. And I'll do something like this, buy two, get one free, right? So if someone uses that coupon code, I can do that. So buy X, and then I go here and I can specify either buy two, get one free, you know, buy a number, get a certain number, or I can do a certain minimum amount. So let's start one by one. So buy two of a specific category, a collection or a product. Let's do a product in this case, but you understand the collection part, right? So product. For example, I want to do this one, right? So let's just say this one. I'm going to copy this name and go here. Okay, and here I have variants. This is why it looks like with an indent, because this product has many colors and sizes. So buy any of the variants of this product and get. So customer buys two of this product, and for example, they get one of the product for free. So specific product, I'm going to search, select all, and do they get it for free or do they get for a certain percentage off, like buy two, get the third one for 20%. So in this case, we're going to do free. I can have the maximum usage per order. I don't want to do that right now. And I'm going to keep everything the same. So now if I go here, okay, let's change this, input, excuse me. Gonna go here. So I did buy two of this Adidas Super 80s, and this is not the same product, right? So you obviously it's not gonna apply. So I'm gonna go here to this product and I'm gonna buy two of them. I'm gonna view my cart and I'm gonna go here to two. Excuse me, I made a mistake. I clicked by mistake. Let me do it again. Here. Add to cart, view cart, add one more quantity, and check out. Okay, so the reason it doesn't apply is because I don't have a third one. So I'd have to actually add a third quantity and then get one of them for free. So let's go back to cart and go here, three, and now it'll apply. So instead of 510, it's only 340, right? So I actually got, you see it split it up. So instead of being three right here, I have two plus one, okay? And now I can proceed to checkout. So that's the concept of this whole thing. So let's first of all disable this. And now let's make the last part, which is the automatic discounts, okay? This is pretty nice, this one, okay? So automatic discounts is very, very similar to the coupon discounts, but you don't have to enter a coupon, and it's just slightly simpler, okay? So let's just say something like, if someone has added at least, you know, $500 into the cart, I'm going to give them 100 off. So again, you can do for types. You can do fixed amount like $100 off or a buy X, get Y or a percentage. So let's do the example. So get 100. And now this is just the name, right? Okay, this is just going to be the name when they see in the cart. So get 100 and it's going to be $100, but it applies, let's say it applies for all products, but you have to have at least 500 in your cart, and I'm going to save it. Okay, summary. Okay, good. So now I don't have any coupons. I don't need that stuff. So if I refresh, okay, I got it. Now, why did I get 100? Obviously, I had $500 in. Okay, so this applies obviously in the checkout page. And let's see what else I have here. This is pretty self-explanatory. That's it pretty much. So hope this makes sense there, everybody. If you have any other questions, something I didn't cover, let me know. Really appreciate you watching the video, and I hope to create a lot more and at least one more tonight. Okay, appreciate it. Thank you very much.